Hi, welcome back to Hostpark's channel and back to Python series, the advanced Python tutorial. And today we're going to see the topic called Pandas, the data science, continuation of data science, Pandas in Python, and why you need Pandas and how to use Pandas. The previous session I explained about what is IPy and how to implement with some real-time examples and how to solve the mathematical and scientific problems also. So let's go for continuation of data science. We already know there are three types of Python libraries, very very big and important. One is called SciPy, one is called Pandas, another one called Matplotlib, like that. So let's go for this one, Pandas. Today the objective course is definitely helpful to learn what is Pandas and why we use Pandas, how to install the Pandas, and also Python Pandas, some of the operations like slicing the data frame, merging and joining, at last concatenation, with some examples with the demonstration also. Now the question is, what is Pandas? Pandas is an open source library that allows to you perform data manipulation in Python, remember. And also it's the Pandas library is built on top of the NumPy, and meaning is Pandas needs NumPy to operate. So when you want to implement Pandas, we need support of NumPy also, based on your application development of data analysis and so on. And also Pandas provide an easy way to create, manipulate and run the data, and is also an elegant solution for time series data. So whenever any database or any whatever the data is there, the lengthy or whatever the employment data, unemployment data, whatever there, we can use the Pandas and do the solution. What kind of solution you want to do it, what kind of problems arise, and how can you develop the solution with the help of Pandas very easily and in the real time. Yes, we use Pandas. There are some reasons there, because it uses series for one dimension data structure and data frame for multi-dimension data structure also, and also easily handles missing data, and also it provides an efficient way to slice the data, and also it provides a flexible way to merge, concatenate and reshape the data. So the upcoming session we are going to see the example. There we'll get the clarity about these points. Let's go for next. And also remember, the Python Pandas is well suited for the different kinds of data. So remember, these are the part of the data science and also part of the data analysis and advanced one. So whenever we go for, we have to import the Pandas. So in the previous session I explained about how to install the Pandas in the command prompt. I already told you, especially in Python IDE 3.80 version. So you can check it out. So after install PAP command, you can use PAP space install space Python Pandas, like that. So once completed means, what you can do, you can go to the Python environment and type import space Pandas as PD, like that. Then no error means the Pandas is successfully installed. That is the way of how to install. Now there are different kinds of data we can operate with Pandas. It is called tabular data with heterogeneously typed columns, and ordered and unordered time series data, and also arbitrary matrix data with row and column labels, unlabeled data, at last any other form of observational or statistical data sets. Everything possible with the help of Python Pandas concept. And just now I told you some operation can perform, that is called we can perform lot of operations, some of the with series, data frames, missing data and group by data and etc also. Some of the common operations we are going to see one by one. First one is called slicing the data frame. Here in order to perform slicing on data, we need a data frame, remember. And also here data frame is what, it's a two dimensional data structure and most common Pandas object. So example, I have a program called p1.pvar script, where I am, first step is what, import Pandas as a PD compulsory for all the Pandas operations. Then I am going to create a data frame where I am going to create the data for day and visitors, x, y, z, comma web, where I am writing the day 1, 2, 3, 4 days. I am going to create, so I am writing 4 days totally, 1, 2, 3, 4, and followed by visitors, first day 1000, second day 700, followed by third day 6000 and so on, fourth day 1000, like that. At bounce rate, we are going to fix some bounce rate also, and I am creating data frame with the help of syntax, that is df equal to pd dot data frame of xyz comma underscore web, at last print df. So whenever you give like this, it will go and print the data, day and visitors table. That is a two dimensional data structure, so simple and easy. So if you want real time, you can change data and check it out. discuss for demonstration. So here in the desktop, I have a file p1.py. Examples one by one. See. So here is the so day one to the there is no problem using this like creating data frames. So many method is there. You can use CSV file also. Let's go for run the program. Yeah, successfully executed. So it printing the day, visitors, and bounce rate. What are the information within the program? So followed by the visitor 1700, 600 and 1000 so on. So like that you can create the data frames with the help of pandas. Just back to PPT here, presentation here. So now next operation and also so we are create a data frame. There will be another two options is there. We can do it, that is called df.headup2 and df.tail. That means if you want to print the first two rows of the data frame, we can use head command. And when you go tail of 2, it will print the last two rows of the data. So let's for execute here. So simple and easy. So when I go like this, we have to use import space pandas space as pd. Yes, there is no error. That means successfully executed. So I can give the above table. Print of df dot head of 2. If you want, you can print only one row or two row or three rows, whatever you want, you can go and give it and check it out. Yeah, successfully executed. So it printing the first two rows of the above two dimensional data frame, and next you can go for tail also. Similarly, tail of is going to print the last two rows of the data. Yeah, successfully executed. So if you have 10 or 12 rows based on that your requirement, it will go on display. So like that you can use and see the result of the slicing operations. Now next one is merging and joining. First we see the merging operation. Merging means what? You know, generally joining the two things. Generally merging means combining the two things. Here in merging, what happens means you can merge two data frames to form a single data frame. You have already separate two data frames, you can make it a single. And also for this one, what you can do means we first create three data frames which has some key value pairs under that, and then merge the data frames together. So let's example, we can say the program called p2.py and p3.py for separate the column. Let's go open the program. Open the desktop. Yeah. So as you know, first step is import pandas as PDF mandatory. Then I'm going to create the data frame 1 is equal df 1 is equal to pd dot data frame of HPI. Some data I'm going to give that the values have 80, 90, 70, comma followed by 60 and so on. And the interest rate will be 2, comma 1, comma 2, comma 3. So four values giving as followed by the four rates. And also IND score underscore GDP values I'm giving 50 comma 45 comma 45 comma 67 comma and so on, followed by index of years. That's 2001, 2002, 2003 and 2004, like that. But similarly, I'm going to create the another data frame that is called DF2 is equal to P dot data frame of same data. And here I'm going to give the information index of values. So two them at last it go and combine and make it a single one, single frame structure to go print. So at last what I can do, if you want merge, you can use a merge command. So merge d is equal to pd dot merge of df1 comma df2. At last print of merge d. That means what? It go and merge the first data frame 1 and followed by merging the data frame 2. Let's go for execute the program or script here. Yeah, successfully executed. So it printing HPI data and interest rate and I into GDP, whatever given the program. Next go for p3.py pandas program, where for separate column, suppose I want to decide separate column, I want to see means I can use over that way. Yeah, here same program. So I'm going to give when I give, so on HPA, so I'm going to go just change here. Merge it is equal to p.merge df1, df2, on score HPA and print up merge it. So when I give like this, it will go and print a separate column. Just go for the data frame itself now. Yeah, successfully executed. So it's saying the results as you recommend. So here it additionally printing the additional printing some values, GDPY and so on, and highlighting the HPA column here. So like that you use the slicing operation and merge operation. Next is joining. So you know it is another method to combine two differently indexed data frames into a single result data frame, remember. And also this is quite similar to the merge operation, except the joining operation will be on the index instead of the columns. So let's go for example here, p4.py program. So here remember what you want to understand means we can combine the two differently indexed data frames and also into a single data frame. So here one data frame is different, another data frame is different, but you can join it. Successfully join and implement in the Python programming. So let's go for p4.py program. Stop. Yeah, so simple and easy. Here I'm going to create the data frame df1 is equal to p dot data frame of int data 2, 1, 2 and ind underscore gdp of some value, and followed by index of years 2001 2011 12 13 14 and so on, and another dft I'm going to create based on that one, and creating the columns called low tire underscore HP of some values, and followed by unemployment, that is 13, 5, 6, and index of 2001, 13, 14, and 14, like that. And at last I want to use joining, so I'm using the join method. So I'm going to give df1 dot join of df2 of. The meaning is what? We are going to join the two above data frames. Let's go and conclude the results. So simple it is. So like that you can different data frames, you can combine it. So based on the DFT2, it go and print the data. Let's execute the program. Yeah, successfully executed. So it's printing the data from 2011 to 14 and so on. Whatever given the values in the program, it won't change anything, just printing the data. It is possible in the Pandas. Let's back to presentation and last to go for another one. It is called concatenation. So simply and easy. Concatenation basically what means glues the data frames together, and also we can select the dimension on which you want to concatenate. So we can select some dimension, based on that one you can do operations. Then for that just use pd.concat and pass in the list of data frames to concatenate together. So let's say a example called p5.py program. There you can understand better way. p5.py program. Yeah. So same data, same just now I told you, know above program. I'm following the same data, but I'm going to use the concat method. That means combining the two things, concat is equal to pd.concat of df1, df2. Let's go for execution. So here also same, what I followed in the previous program, same, and change the year values, index and the year values here, and try to use the concat method. Lengthy line, I don't want to image it. Yes, let's go for execute and the Python program. Yeah. So successfully executed the above program. So concurrent. So it's going to print the data from 2011 to 18 and all the information HPI interest rate. Sorry, HPI data and interest rate at last. IND score GDP also. So before one not possible. Okay. So that is the use of concatenation in the Python concept. Python with pandas. I hope you understand what is pandas, why we need pandas, and how to install pandas, how to perform and implement and do some operation with Python real time. And moreover, if you want as a beginner, if you are beginning with these are sufficient. If you want, you can extend with the CSV files method. That means if you have CLC file, you can read, download the CSV file and convert to the HTML file with the data monging method and so on. Thank you for watching this video and please subscribe and share with your friends and stay connected with social media. Thank you.